the like expressions of horror when he's watching Hunchback. Owen embodies these films. He lives with these films. And anytime he has a problem in his life, he goes to a film for his guidance to understand what's happening in his life and in the world. This was a boy who was completely withdrawn, completely lost. He didn't have verbal skills. He couldn't make eye contact. He had no connection to the world. And look at him now. These films were a way of him to find a pathway back. My name is Roger Ross Williams, and my film is Life Animated. It's about a young kid who lost his ability to speak and communicate with the world, and he got autism around 3 years old, and then immersed himself in Disney animated films. It's as much a film about parenting, you know, about love, about the closeness of a family, because they loved Owen so much that they were going to connect with him any way they could. They were going to find a way to connect to their son. And that's what's so amazing, is they went against all the advice they got from the professionals, because they were told to restrict his viewing of Disney films. But they said, no, if this is what he loves and this is what he connects with, we're going to embody them. We're going to become animated characters.
Owen. How does it feel to be you?
And I said, not good, because I don't have any friends.
Okay. Owen, when did you and I become such good friends?
At that point, it was like a window opened, like a light went on.
His brother, Walt, he really speaks for a lot of siblings. So much attention and focus goes to the child with autism, and the siblings a lot of times feel left out. Walt and Owen have started a movement to support siblings in America, and they just did their first talk together at a conference, and Walt is sort of leading the movement of siblings. Even on our sort of festival run, the Susskinds have been with me the whole time. And always they're not just parents, but people living with autism who come up to Owen and say, this is the first time I've seen myself on screen. It was important to me that Owen told his own story. So what I did was I used an Interitron, which is a camera invented by Earl Morris, the documentarian, which is a television screen. And I am not in the room. Owen is looking at me on a television screen. If we were sitting there talking like this, Owen wouldn't necessarily make eye contact with me. But he spent his whole life looking at a television screen. He can tell his story and look me directly in the eye when I'm on screen. So that was the way that I got around the autism. And so the other thing I did was I had a little A-B switch. And I would switch, and if I wasn't on the screen, I would play one of his favorite scenes from a Disney classic film, and he would interact with that scene. So it has this sort of great effect of bringing the audience into Owen's world and Owen's reality. And there's so many sort of layers of animation in the film, because there's the Disney clips, there's the Land of the Lost Sidekicks animation, and then there's the backstory animation, and those are done in black and white line drawing. It was also unprecedented for Disney to allow us to redraw their characters. Julie Goldman, my producer, and I went to Disney, and we took them on a journey through the film and what the film would be, and they were in tears afterwards because they just were so moved that their work could change someone's life. I mean, story is how we connect with each other. Now, what's happening because of the book and because of the film, they are studying how to connect with someone with autism through their affinity, through what they love. What's happening is that this whole movement, this new movement in the world of autism, is starting because of the Susskinds and because they stumbled upon this. And that's really exciting. Mm-hmm.